Today we shall discuss the easy clinical grading of extraocular movements. Abnormal ocular motility can either be underaction or overaction. Regardless, when grading them on a 9-point scale, 0 refers to full movement, minus numbers underaction and plus numbers overaction. Minus 1, 2 and 3 refer to 25, 50 and 75% of underaction respectively, and minus 4 means that the eye cannot move past the midline. The plus numbers refer to similar percentages of overaction. Now, how do we know what normal movement is? If you note the lacrimal punctum, in maximal adduction, the junction of the medial one-third and lateral two-thirds of the cornea lies adjacent to the lacrimal punctum. Similarly, for abduction, the temporal limbus just touches the lateral canthus in maximal abduction. Now, let's look at what each of these gradings could look like. In attempted dextroversion, if there is no movement past the midline, the abduction in the right eye and the adduction in the left eye would be graded as minus 4. Here, there is only minimal movement and so would be graded as minus 3. A little greater movement would be minus 2. A minimal deficit of movement, minus 1. Note here that for abduction deficit, a small bit of sclera is seen, and for adduction deficit, the junction of the medial and middle third of the cornea has not yet reached the level of the punctum. And normal movements are graded as 0. Vertical movements may be similarly graded based on the approximate percentage of movement deficit. Another method of grading motility is the Limbus Test of Kestenbaum. This is more precise as measurement is less subjective compared to the previous method. For measuring horizontal movements, a millimeter ruler is placed in front of the cornea with its edge horizontal to the cornea. The examiner must place his face in front of the patient's such that his right eye is in front of the patient's left eye and vice versa. So, if the right eye is to be tested, the patient must look at the examiner's left eye so that the eye being tested is straight. If measuring abduction, the position on the ruler of the nasal limbus is noted in the primary position and then in maximum abduction, and the excursion is measured in millimeters. For adduction, the movement of the nasal limbus is noted. For elevation, the inferior limbus, and for depression, the superior limbus. For vertical movements, the ruler is placed vertically. The normal values are 9 to 10 millimeters for abduction, adduction, and depression, and 5 to 7 millimeters for elevation. If one wishes to express the movement in terms of degrees or prism diopters, conversion can be done using the equivalency of 1 millimeter to 5 degrees or 10 prism diopters. When testing for oblique muscle dysfunction, it is important to ensure that the abducting eye is fixing so that the adducting eye, which manifests the oblique muscle dysfunction, can be assessed. Placing an occluder in front of the adducting eye can prevent it fixating. In all these examples, the oblique muscle in the right eye is abnormal. Here, there's a right inferior oblique underaction and the muscle is not able to elevate enough. The right superior oblique is the agonist of the right eye in levodepression. The underaction is clearly visible here. Inferior oblique overaction and superior oblique overaction in adduction are visible here.